Hello guys, this is Indian Medico and in this video we are going to see about myringotomy. This is a concise presentation for medical students. The term myringa refers to the eardrum or tympanic membrane. Tomy means cutting, so myringotomy literally means cutting of tympanic membrane. Myringotomy is also known as tympanotomy or tympanostomy. Tympanocentesis is another procedure similar to myringotomy. Myringotomy is a surgical procedure in which a tiny incision is created in the tympanic membrane to relieve pressure caused by excessive buildup of fluid or to drain pus from the middle ear. To be clear, myringotomy is incision of the tympanic membrane to drain suppurative or non-suppurative effusion of the middle ear or to provide aeration in case of malfunctioning eustachian tube by inserting a ventilation tube or grommet. This picture depicts a myringotomy. An incision is made into the tympanic membrane and a tube is placed with the help of forceps. Now let us see a trivia about myringotomy. In 1649, Jean Riolan the Younger accidentally pierced a patient's eardrum while cleaning it with an ear spoon. Surprisingly, the patient's hearing improved. This is thought to be the first recorded case of myringotomy. Now let us see about the indications of myringotomy. Myringotomy can be done in cases of acute suppurative otitis media when there is severe earache with bulging tympanic membrane or there is incomplete resolution with opaque drum and persistent conductive deafness, that is when the acute suppurative otitis media does not relieve with antibiotics and when there are complications of otitis media like facial paralysis, labyrinthitis or meningitis with bulging tympanic membrane. Myringotomy can be done for cases of otitis media with effusion or serous otitis media. It can be done for aero-otitis media to drain fluid and unlock the eustachian tube. It can also be done for atelectic ear. An atelectic ear is one in which the tympanic membrane is retracted. In this case, the grommet is often inserted for long-term aeration. What are the contraindications for myringotomy? Myringotomy is avoided in cases of suspected intratympanic glomus tumor. This is because of the risk of profuse bleeding in these cases. What is the anesthesia used for myringotomy? Myringotomy can be done under local anesthesia or no anesthesia at all. However, general anesthesia is given for infants, children, and in adults when tympanic membrane is acutely inflamed. What are the steps of myringotomy? The ear canal is cleaned of wax and debris. The apparatus needed are an operating microscope, a sharp myringotome, a good suction apparatus, and a ventilation tube. In cases of acute suppurative otitis media, a circumferential incision is given in the posteroinferior quadrant between handle of malleus and tympanic annulus. We should take care to avoid injury to the incrusted epidural joint. In cases of otitis media with effusion, a small radial incision is given in the posteroinferior or anteroinferior quadrant. If ventilation tube is to be inserted, the incision should be just enough to admit the tube. What are the pitfalls of myringotomy? In cases of thick tympanic membrane, the incision may remain in the superficial layers of eardrum without cutting through the entire thickness. We can also accidentally make an incision in the posterior meatal wall. This is because the distinction between the drum head and posterior meatal wall is lost when both are inflamed. Now let us see about the postoperative care. In cases of acute suppurative otitis media, daily mopping of ear discharge is necessary. In cases of otitis media with effusion, leave a wad of cotton wool for 24 to 48 hours. A drum incision heals rapidly. However, no water should be permitted in the ear canal for at least 1 week or for as long as the grommet is in position. Now let us see about the complications of myringotomy. If myringotomy is not performed properly, it can lead to incudostapedial joint injury or injury to stapes. There can also be injury to the jugular bulb leading to profuse bleeding. This occurs when the jugular bulb is high and the floor of the middle ear is dehiscent. Myringotomy can also lead to middle ear infections. Thank you.